Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to be talking about what the big deal with the natural base e is. I remember seeing this value tons when I was first learning calculus, and spent a long time not truly understanding why it is so cool and useful. So let's take some time now and I'll introduce you to why e is awesome. E is an irrational number, meaning that we can't represent it by one integer over another. And because of this, it doesn't end. It just goes on and on forever, just like pi, for example. It is defined as 1 plus 1 over n, all to the power of n. N can be any value. However, the larger n we pick, the more accurate our approximation of the irrational number will be. So, in our previous video, we began talking about exponential functions. Well, e to the power of x is known as the natural exponential function. But what does that really mean? Well, as we talked about in the previous video, exponential functions are denoted like so. Remember that this b term is our base, so when we say base e, we could just as easily say base 2.71828 and keep going. But since this is an irrational number, and so common, we just use e to denote it. We call e the natural exponential function because of all the potential base values for our exponential function, e is the best. Although there were some early uses of this irrational constant, the first functional use of this constant was in the late 1600s, where Jacob Bernoulli was studying compound interest. Bernoulli was studying how the frequency of compounding the interest would affect the value of the money. Well, what Bernoulli found was that the following equation can be used to determine the value of money in a year, where r is the interest rate and n is the compounding periods in the year, and t is the number of years. Well, this looks really familiar, doesn't it? By setting our interest rate to 100%, and our period, 1 year, we get our natural exponential function. And assuming infinite compounding, we can actually just express this as a continuous compounding equation. This also applies to other areas in science, such as biology and population rates of bacteria, which grow exponentially, and many other fields. But again, we should be asking why. Why is e, a random irrational number, the best base for our exponential function? Well, let's firstly just draw the function. F of x equals e to the power of x. In your future calculus courses, you'll learn about derivatives, which is just a line that just touches our function of interest at a single point, and tells us the instantaneous rate of change at that point. The cool thing about our natural exponential function is that any derivative is just equal to the output value. So, this means that the derivative of our natural exponential function is just itself. The really cool thing about this is the only function that this is true for. We have also been talking about inverse functions. The inverse of a natural exponential function is the natural logarithm, which you may see as ln. So we use this natural logarithm to unpack the natural exponential e. So if you had a function f of x is equal to 4x, we can solve for x like so. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding of why e is such a cool number in math. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our Patreon page to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.